After years of talk and development, large-scale 3D printing technology is finally coming of age and starting to enter the construction industry. The technique is steadily evolving from novelty to practical application, and the prospect of seeing 3D printed houses in towns and cities around the world is now looking increasingly likely. "3D printing is the process of creating a three-dimensional object by laying down many layers of a material in succession. On an industrial scale, this has many advantages over traditional manufacturing techniques and has fast become a valuable tool for rapid prototyping in the manufacturing sector. If successfully scaled and applied in the construction and engineering industries, it could reduce on-site time and project costs. It also has advantages for sustainable construction, as very little material is ever wasted during the build process. Several organizations around the world are now racing to effectively scale 3D printing and to develop viable solutions for the building sector, with a particular focus on housing. We've rounded up the current frontrunners. Perhaps more than any other company, Shanghai-based Winsun have captured the world's imagination when it comes to 3D printing full-scale buildings. Winsun generated headlines back in 2014 when they claimed to have printed not one, but 10 houses in a single day. The single-story detached properties were created using four large printers, each standing 20 feet or some 6.6 meters tall. At a cost of around $4,800 US each, the houses were printed from a concrete aggregate that was part formed from recycled construction waste. Although the houses are not very refined, they certainly captured the world's attention. Initiated by DUS architects, Canal House is an ongoing attempt to print a full-scale, classic canal-side house in the center of Amsterdam. Partially funded by the municipality of Amsterdam, the 13-room home is being developed as a publicly accessible research project to investigate the potential of various materials and techniques. The team are working with a 6-meter-tall printer that uses sustainable bioplastics containing over 80% vegetable oil. Inside the printer, granular plastic is heated to 170 degrees Celsius before being compressed to form a homogeneous liquid. This is then extruded from the printer head to create each component. The components are being printed on site, piece by piece, and then assembled. In the United States, architects Skidmore, Owings, Merrill have worked in partnership with the US Department of Energy's Oak Ridge National Laboratory to create a 3D printed prototype pavilion. Formed in a reinforced carbon fiber material, the 38 feet 11.6 meter long building was the world's largest 3D printed polymer structure when it was first completed. The pavilion is composed of 3D printed panels that act as exterior cladding while providing structural support, insulation, and moisture protection. Solar panels integrated into the roof feed a generator under the building, which in turn powers the structure's lighting at night. Dubai's Office of the Future claims to be the most advanced 3D printed building in the world. The 2,600 square foot, 250 square meter structure was completed in 2016 and now houses the Dubai Future Foundation. Designed by US architectural practice Gensler, the office was printed by Winsun in Shanghai using a 20 foot or 6 meter tall 3D printer before being shipped to Dubai. Printing took 17 days in total, and the full installation was completed on site in just 48 hours. Subsequent work on the building services, interiors, and landscape took approximately 3 months to complete. The project team estimate that 3D printing reduced labor costs by 50% and construction waste by more than 30%. While not technically a house, this office clearly demonstrates the quality of buildings that can now be achieved with 3D printing. The Office of the Future looks set to be the first of many 3D printed structures in Dubai. The government has announced that it aims to be 3D printing 25% of all new buildings in the emirate by 2030. Currently leading the pack is a house that was printed in less than 24 hours in 2017. The $10,000 building is the closest anyone has come to 3D printing a fully formed house. Created by San Francisco-based startup Apis Core, working with the Russian home building company Pick Group, the house was printed at a test site just south of Moscow. While 3D printing a home typically involves manufacturing components off-site and then assembling on-site, this 400 square foot, 38 square meter house was printed entirely in situ. It was formed with an impressive large-scale mobile 3D printer, which has a rotating manipulator arm capable of covering a 1400 square foot or 130 square meter area from a single point. The printer was removed from the center of the new house once the structural elements had been formed. Insulation was then placed in the walls before the roof and windows were added and finishes applied. The result was a fully functioning home. With the first 3D printed skyscraper now being mooted in Dubai and the Saudi Arabian government inviting Winsome to print 1.5 million homes over the next 5 years, it seems we'll be seeing much more large-scale 3D printing in the construction sector. If you enjoyed this video and would like to get more from the definitive video channel for construction, subscribe to the B1M.